The news conference was held here at St. Paul AME Baptist Church in North St. Louis this afternoon, where Terry Tillman's family and community leaders gathered demanding action. This is video released for the first time. It was captured by two women who were inside a beauty shop. They watched as officers worked the crime scene outside. Community leaders claim the video shows a Richmond Heights police officer walking to a police car after the shooting. He's wearing a blue rubber glove on his hand. The activists claim the officer grabbed a weapon and walked towards the scene where Tillman was shot and killed. Community leaders say the scene was already secured and allege that Terry Tillman had a weapon and would be next to his body. They are making strong allegations the weapon was planted on Tillman. St. Louis County Police, who are handling the investigation, had not seen the video until today. But two officers who saw Tillman inside the Galleria say he had an extended magazine on his gun. They approached Tillman because guns are not allowed on Galleria property. Investigators say Tillman ran from officers. They chased him and alerted dispatch about the chase. Other officers arrived, and county police say a Richmond Heights police officer shot and killed Tillman in the parking garage near the Galleria after Tillman raised his gun at officers.
The video shows that the Richmond Heights police corrupting the crime scene by actually getting a gun out of the Richmond Heights SUV and putting gloves on and firing the weapon that supposedly been Terry Tillman had to the scene where he was actually killed. And so what we're saying that he did not have that weapon at the time that he was actually shot.
Police view the video for the first time today and release the following statement. The actions taken by law enforcement on scene, including the securing Mr. Tillman's weapon after the shooting, were known and have been documented in the investigation. In other words, police say the video shows officers securing the gun after officers recovered the gun from the shooting scene. They also say we have and will continue to contact persons that may have information pertaining to this incident. In some cases, we have been met with resistance and refusal. In addition, police say they have known about the video since asking for the public's help in August. However, they say both women involved in shooting the video have refused to talk with police, provide their names, or share the video with investigators. In North St. Louis, I'm Kelley Hoskins. Missouri.